$400 could have been used for something else other than going to get a second opinion because a gentleman may not have liked my color.
All new at 11 on 7 Eyewitness News, investigating multiple complaints of racial bias related to the hiring process for Buffalo police officers and firefighters. At the center of all of this, a Rochester-based doctor who the city has contracted to evaluate the psychological well-being of prospective candidates.
But as 7 Eyewitness News reporter Dave Thompson explains in this iTeam report, some see the issue here as going far beyond one individual.
All of the information that I've received from several of the gentlemen who spoke today is correct. We have a problem.
Strong words from Buffalo Common Council President Darius Pridgen as the Civil Service Committee investigates claims of racial bias and the way police and fire candidates are vetted by the city. Half a dozen speakers shared their stories of what they feel was racial bias during Tuesday's meeting. They say after a short psychological evaluation, they were deemed unfit by Dr. Jay Supnick, who is based in Rochester. Many of those same candidates say they sought a second opinion. And Jason Cannon, who now works for an insurance company, says the findings of that exam contradicted Dr. Supnick's evaluation.
After a 10 to 15 minute interview, he had me sized up to be this pretty much unintelligible. A man without integrity, and then when I drove to Albany and got a second opinion from one of his colleagues, the recommendation was that I was recommended to be a City of Buffalo firefighter.
According to city records, Dr. Supnick did more than $100,000 of consulting work with the city during the 2017 fiscal year, often providing psychological exams, one of the final barriers into the Buffalo police or fire departments. We spoke with Dr. Supnick on the phone Tuesday evening. He tells 7 Eyewitness News he can't comment until speaking with the city's Human Resources Commissioner. The city responded through spokesperson Mike DeGeorge, saying, "The data reveals absolutely no indication of racial bias. With new leadership in place, the mayor has already directed the new fire commissioner and the interim police commissioner to review all aspects of the hiring process for fire and police with the Commissioner of Human Resources. Any changes to the process will be implemented before the next class of police and fire." But some feel it's the system, not Dr. Supnick, that's the problem. One woman says this was an issue 10 years ago when a different doctor deemed her unfit to serve with the Buffalo Police, despite already working in law enforcement.
"I was the only black officer in Allegheny County and the only female in my department. I had a bachelor's degree when this man interviewed me and said I was emotionally unfit because I got teary-eyed about my ex-boyfriend, who also was a police officer, who shot himself in the head."
And here at City Hall, council members are looking to overhaul the psychiatric evaluation system and put an end to their contract with Dr. Supnick.
I, for one, will not vote for this individual if he comes before us again. I think we should exercise our 30-day clause to get out of the business with him.
Dave Thompson, 7 Eyewitness News.